I got bad news. I'm not rocking no more Nike shit on this channel. You want me to wear some Nike? We gonna have to have a meeting. I'm done free advertising your shit. You wanna know why Nike needs to take a meeting with Shawn C? This is why. Nobody go to the Nike store ever again in your whole life. That's why. Phil Knight. Bill Bowerman. That's just how we rocking. Alright, we only repping Detroit from this side. This is John Vervaso, I think. Don't ask me to get up because I'm not wearing Nike sweats, I swear to God. Anyway, Amine has just dropped a new thing. Because I don't know if this is a mixtape or an album. It's a surprise little project, I guess. It doesn't really seem like it's that long. I kind of want to hop into it right away. I do like Amine's singing, harmonizing voice. What was the one track off of Good For You? I think it was called Sunday. I haven't listened to that in a while, but now that I'm listening to Amine, or I know I'm about to, I kind of want to go back and listen to that song because that was one of my favorites off the album. I like this dude's versatility. I like that he has some soul in his voice. I like that his singing is organic and natural, even if it isn't accompanied by any grand production. I still just like him singing. Even if I don't always like it, I still like that he attempts to keep it natural to the basics, doesn't try to do too much. Like the way the dude moves, so I don't really think this project is going to be anything crazy, but I don't really think, you know, it coming from Mine, I'm not going to be entertained either. So let's hop in and see what we're going to get. The album is called, or whatever this thing is called, 1.5. I'm hoping this was put in the right order. There should be 13 tracks, so the first one I'm going to listen to is Together. I'm so excited.
I didn't mean to suck, I'm stuck, sometimes I'm just too honest.
I see what you did. Now that right there, that's nice. So I don't really mind the first track. I mean, Amine is a character that tends to rap about romantic encounters. Don't mind them being in the music. Look, we're gonna keep going, but the way dude talks about relationships is just like, it's not my cup of tea. Like, I get it, but it's just like, I don't really think he handles the relationship perspective musically in like a very unique way. So that's why I feel like when I go into it, I feel like I've already heard it before. Next track, Rachet, Saturn Girl.
I'm Rachet, I like my bitch bad. I like a freaky little mama who gon' throw it back. I like them 40-inch nails, they don't eat too. I call it little mama when the lips close. I like when shawty do the dummy on my dick raw.
First of all, I like when shawty do the dummy on my dick raw. That just flows out so effortlessly. He said, I like when the lip gloss. I see when her lip gloss, I call her little mama. That shit is great.
Go picture on my left, cause it's my best side. I like my ratchet, I like my bitch bad. I like a freaky little mama who won't throw it back.
No, it sounds like, I don't know whatever instrument that is, but it sounds like it's hitting other objects while it's falling down. Somebody's picking it up and putting it back at the top, and it's dropping down, hitting more objects as it comes back down. Like, that's the way the hook sounds to me. I like the track, like the beat switch. I think it happens really smooth. I don't really mind the singing again. There's nothing crazy happening when it comes to how he's describing his love for this woman. But the beginning of the track I actually do prefer, and I get why he's calling her a Saturn girl, because she's out of this world. Next track, Shut the Fuck Up 2. I'm gonna be pissed if I'm listening to this shit out of order.
And it's 4 milli in a can, the size of Pop's caravan. My wingspan 7 foot, right hand, get a hook.
My speakers.
I got a new bitch, like I'm Ben Simmons. My ego keep frontin' on my niggas, keep styling.
I don't know, I like that track. You know, obviously the bass is being abused. Y'all know I'm a fan of that. I just think one of the more appealing parts of Amine is how he's not really, I guess, an aggressive kind of rapper. So, I mean, for that track, it was a little, I won't say it was off-putting, but it was a little different from what I normally get or what I'm normally used to from this type of music. It's a little bit more chill, laid back, doesn't really take the situations and things too seriously. Not as laid back as like a Wiz Khalifa, but like, you know, in the realm where it's just like a chill dude. I am listening to this backwards. Okay, let's go to Amine Cantu.
I hear it down.
That's why it's called Cantu. Alright.
Hey girl, wanna touch it? I told her, please don't touch me. She said, who the fuck is your stylist? I told that bitch my cousin.
Oh.
Picked out Cantu in my hurt. Out the fucking window.
This is, I get it. I love it.
Don't ask me just to pet me, cause you can't.
only has that shit happened to me so much before, because even probably up until I was 12 is when I got like my first official haircut, and I used to have like really, really long hair, and I don't think it was thick enough at the time for me to make a dread out of it, but I had like really long, like one really long braid, sometimes just really long, multiple braids or whatever, and people would always want to touch my shit. I'm like, stop. I don't want to, don't touch me. Don't touch me. You're not qualified. And I cut all my hair off, and then I started growing it back out again, and I started having these little coils and curls and, you know, kind of a dread-ish pattern, like kind of similar to the way I have it now. People still wanted to touch my shit, and it would be the Beckys and the Samanthas and the Jessicas. Oh my god, I've never seen someone like you before. Face ass. I love this track. Next track, Dr. Whoever.
Every time you walk in a room, you break necks.
Isn't that that dude off of, either he was a Viner or an Instagrammer.
Can't man up if masculinity your only weapon. Man, I've thought about suicide 100 times. But I hate to disappoint and see my mama cry. He hates that I left home and the lawn is now his to mow it. He look at my generation.
He's going. He's going. Like I said, it don't have to be anything crazy, but speaking your reality is coming off authentic. I'm feeling it. It's flowing into me. Relax. I didn't even mean it like that.
Just if she ever model fashion over. I'm always on a flight. Or I'm in milkshakes for the only time we need a cherry. I think learning how to eat pussy from someone who eat pussy is better. These intros ain't meant to be bangers. They meant for you and me, so we'll never end up as strangers. Look. Boy, you looking big mad when you see a young brother up in first class. And you damn right my ego like a volleyball. They hate to see a black man who can't get black from black in my teeth. That having plaques on the wall. Gold album with platinum records. Who that want my children? My net worth gonna be millions. Try to give me hands like ceiling. Think there's a
love it.
To all my niggas with some melanin. Let your feelings settle in. If you feeling worthless, you should probably go and tell a friend.
That, hands down, is the best track so far. I really love Cantu, and even going back to Cantu when he said my stylist is my cousin, that's really how it is. But with this track, I just think really open. He's very relatable, very open. Even in the ending portion of the track where he's talking about how, you know, if you're black, take care of your mental, you know, and let people know when you're not feeling the best, because you don't want to let that manifest. Also saying in the middle of the track, right before we get to the point where the bass goes crazy, saying that you're basically my therapist and we need to have this open relationship and dialogue with one another so that we can know each other. I think he's very relatable in this song too. Very open, not really trying to be braggadocious or anything like that, just talking and expressing himself. Even saying in the beginning of this track how if masculinity is your only weapon as a man, you're gonna have it rough. And that's why the track is called Dr. Whoever, because whoever's listening to this, you're my therapist for the song. And I love the message of that. Next track, Hiccup, that features Gunna.
I got a shift. Youngest nigga popping shit. Don't want no kids,
it's
better shit.
Oh, shit. Why do y'all always change it when I start singing? The fuck? I definitely think Gunna or Amine chose a good song to put Gunna on, because on this track I feel his aesthetic is a little bit better. I still have issues with his rhyming and his flow a little bit, but he sounds a lot more appropriate on this track than I've heard him on other tracks in the past. I actually like Amine on this track too. It sounds kind of like he's taking the piss out of the auto-crooning by just being a little bit over the top with it at some moment, so I end up enjoying it because it seems like he's not taking it too seriously. Next track, Reel It In.
I got the bag, tell a friend. She got some eyes, bring it in. Bitch, I'm the new CNN.
You do it in a string, bro.
I'm Kobe, I'm never gonna dish shit. But I might pull up COB and slide. Reel it in. I got the bag, tell a friend. Buy that shit before I even know the price. This 13K up on my
I'm not there yet.
Right.
It's coming.
Kind of she Bjork cute. So she really fine, just sort of weird. And she got some K. Give me OPP.
Hey, you only need a couple things to make a track addictive, and like bass, instrument, Amine. That's it. makes it very simple. There's a very simple tactic and approach to the tracks thus far. There's nothing over the top when it comes to the production, but it makes him stand out a bit more when there's less going on in the background, because he's kind of like it's kind of like he's aware of the fact that he would be the highlight of the album. There are artists that try to divert attention from themselves and their lyrics by, you know, adding way more in their features or way more in their production, which makes sense if you know where you're lacking, but I like that he keeps it to the artistry. I also like that these tracks are kind of short so far because they don't drag on for too long. He gives good enough verses with the time that he allows himself, and then he gets out. Next track, we got Blackjack.
Adam got a new drip. I'm a nappy headed black little cool kid. Yeah, I stack that, make
this
that,
is what the
that,
fuck I mean.
Got 100 ways I can flip that, get back. All up in the money just to get back.
Like,
back
listen up. To no, you this dude. Low.
Can't afford my price. This a white tee. I'm the best in the group chat. My niggas won't admit that.
Me too.
30, I put that on my mama, nigga, no cap. Look, I handed a yo. He handed
look, Amine, I fuck with you, man. I really do. But I'm getting tired of everybody hopping on trends. Nobody was saying no cap until earlier this year, bro. Stop. You're not from there. Stop.
This that CLBN. Go ahead, bump it with mom. Says she wanna spot on my long black fly to fight. Can't afford my price.
God this so damn. Yeah, I'm feeling it so far. The next track we got is Why. Why is the album actually better than I thought it would be? Sounds like somebody's got the speaker in their mouth. They just took it out.
Why? Keep my head depressed. I'm a fool, I'm a mess. But my first priority is never second best. Driving down. Says she wanna talk, but I hope it's not a baby. Oh, I wonder why. Yes, I'm the taker, get the bag. Fuck it, let's just count it fast.
Oh my god.
It feels like a rush.
Why? Oh my god, the end of that track just threw me for a loop. I was liking it at first, it was okay, didn't love it, but the end of that, also on that track, Why, it wasn't one of my favorites because he sounds a bit like Ellie Solstre or Eli Solstre, so maybe that's a little bit why too. Next track is called Shine.
You're a catch, but I'm not a receiver. I'm nervous, what is my turn in time? Shine, as you call your canopy, face me moisturized.
Again, I like the R&B, or I want to say R&B, I like the tracks here that are supposed to emphasize the romantic area or side of his life. I guess, like I said, the only reason I don't really enjoy it that much is because it's not really spoken about in any unique ways. It feels like he's just adding more content to the pool of tracks from the thousands of other artists that have all described a love situation in a very similar way, even in ways that he's described himself. So I'm not really saying that this track is bad. It's just something that I find as in one ear and out the other. It doesn't really do much. Next track we got here is called Chingy. Oh,
shit. Right there like I'm Chingy, man. Tell her come through when she leaving the party. Taking it down. Couple of rounds. Bitch, I'm Amine, you know what's allowed. Checking my count. Make sure it's right. What's your avenue? Oh, you know so-and-so. Okay, then you cool. Yeah, silly me.
How it is.
Phone off, you can't locate. See what I need more, bitch.
Yeah, didn't get much from that track other than him flossing, you know, talking about where he's at. I like the bass, most importantly. Again, a lot of attention to Amine. So there's really a lot less going on in the background. So, I mean, I like it. Next track, Dapperdan featuring G Herbo.
Party look lame, I'ma have to pass. Cause I'm fresh in the flesh. A bitch, a boy, a Borat, and a Boris mixed with Maury. I'm out here with Topanga like I'm white and my name Corey. See, looks like you a lame old goofy. We don't ever love thoughts of the goobies. That's worth of my OG boozy. I'm on the chat.
It's almost like he's saying he's a bad bitch.
Say I'm getting money, you accurate. Never see me round no accurate. This hill cat's a
accurate.
Lay like my name Drake. It gave up for a fate. My jewels is custom made.
It's a flex track. That's it. Flex track. Flex, 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 flex. G Herbo, I love this dude, but would it kill you to rap on beat just once, please? The beat is right there. You just gotta stay on the bass drops. That's all you gotta do. Stop doing what the fuck you want to do. It's like it's right here and he's going everywhere else around it. And the last track, Sugarparents, I think that's what it's called. Rico Nasty.
I ain't one of these old heads. If you give me black China, I'ma leave you on red. My money is my money, so I put it in my car. Here's some advice, bitch.
Whoa,
go get.
Whoa, wait. You're not just about to skip past all that. You're not doing it. Fuck, now I gotta hear the bar again.
Get a job. Charlie can't, she can't Southwest. Look, baby, I ain't one of these old heads. If you give me black China, I'ma leave you on red. My money is my money, so I put it in my.
I ain't one of these old heads. If you give me black China, I'ma leave you on red. I don't know how many entendres that is, honestly, but I feel like it's two. Double. I ain't an old head, so if you give me black China, I'ma leave you on red. Like, he could be referencing Foxy Brown's Black China album. Or and saying I'm not an old head, so if you send me some old ass bullshit playlist, I'm gonna leave you on red. Also, though, if you give me Black China, that's old head, like the Black China head video that we saw a couple months ago, not that long ago, which it was an atrocity. It should be deleted from the internet. That was the worst thing I've ever seen in my entire existence of the planet of the earth. Saying if I ever experience that from you, I'm also gonna leave you on red. Since it's Black China, it's old head, it's in the past, but it's head. You see what I'm saying?
That's facts on facts on facts. Gold diggers wanna all access pass.
Look at my money, baby. I got me a lot. I'm on retail, you gotta pay attention to the details. Always money when I check my email. Hotel by the seashore, got plenty seashells on my own car, and I ain't lease it. I can spend it on you, but I ain't easy. He want me to buy him shoes, he ain't worth shoe strings when it get into the
shop. Be Sugarparents if the only person you're paying for is a girl if you're Amine, or the only person you're paying for is a man if you're Rico Nasty. You can't have Sugarparents because you can't have two people that both want you at the same time unless they're bisexual, and you also got to be bisexual. So to have parents, you have to be on both sides of the fence, getting dick and getting vagina. I went to a weird place. Delete that from the video because that was too much. That was also Amine 1.5. Enjoyed the project. I don't really think there was that much in terms of any kind of significant detail that it was trying to work out. I don't really think that the album or the mixtape, let's just call it a project. I don't really think the project went out of its way to try to push Amine into any new conversations or any new discussions or anything like that. I think he's doing what he's been doing. I just think there's heavier emphasis placed on it with this lack of production going on in the background and heavy reliance on things like the bass drop and the bass line, the beat switches and everything like that. I think with emphasis on that, you get to see a little bit more of Amine himself. He's not really drowned out or covered in any kind of instrumental. So if you love Amine, you're going to hear a lot of him in this project, and you're going to hear him very clear. That lack of production could also make some of these tracks blend in the similar way that, you know, a lot of them don't have a lot going on other than Amine. So if you want that flashy, luscious, very grand, very vibrant production, it's not likely to be found on this project. Again, it's just being a project. I don't really expect much from it when it comes to how flashy it is, when it comes to the production, the musicality of it. There are still very musically pleasing tracks on here, like Cantu, like the opening track, I believe, which would be the opening track, Dr. Whoever. Amine is very realistic in the way he tackles this album. He's not going crazy just because he has money now, but he's also acknowledging the idea that he's in a far superior bracket than he was before, and the people that are hating on him are generally the people that are still hanging around at the bottom of the totem pole. Even going as far as to reference those people he feels that are hating on him, like on the track Shut the Fuck Up 2, or Chingy. I don't really like the way he tackles the romantic portion of the album, the tracks where he's supposed to be a little bit more expressive emotionally with a woman. I get what he's doing, but they all come across in a very similar way, and they don't really come off very creative or explorative with the ideas. I mean, metaphor or something more than just baby I love you. The premise of these tracks romantically are just far too simplistic for my simple brain anyway to want to keep, you know, reiterating. Like, I don't want to keep going through the same thing of baby I love you, you're out of this world, you broke my heart, I'm good now, I want you, come back. Like, it's the same shit. He doesn't come off as goofy as he used to, I guess, and on this album he seems a lot more confident. a lot more in his lane, in his pocket. I really enjoy his rapping on this album because there's a lot of moments where he switches up his flow. And the flow is a really important thing for me because it changes the way you listen to a song and the way you have to listen to a song, because it might change the tempo, it might change the emotion. So it'll change the way you listen to the song. Those flow switches are definitely good for not only Amine as a versatile rapper, but for me as a listener of the music. I won't really say there's any filler content in this either. I mean, obviously these are things that are important to Amine at the moment. And 1.5 is kind of like, in my opinion, what I would describe the album or the project as is a prelude. Like, maybe this isn't a full album, but this is where I'm at the moment. You know, I think he's just enjoying his current moment. So I really won't say any of this is filler, because I think it's still all coming from a very genuine place. And I don't think anything here is just said just to be said. That being said, Amine could still, like I said, work on having more vocal inflections, being a little bit more expressive as a singer, getting better features. I really enjoyed the Rico Nasty one, but the G Herbo one wasn't really hitting for me. The Gunna one wasn't really hitting for me. All in all, I think, you know, Amine has a comfort zone or an area that he feels most comfortable in. And he doesn't really go outside of that too often on this album. Yes, I know he's a good rapper and he's improved lyrically and the way he raps. I just don't really think he's gone out of his way to challenge himself artistically. The concept of this album is still reminiscent of Good For You, and the way he raps about these things is still reminiscent of his older projects and older music. So while that isn't a huge problem for me, it makes listening to the album a little bit predictable. But that's just me. I still enjoyed it. Still thought it was a pretty decent project, pretty good listen. A good amount of tracks on here that I will be bumping, like Cantu, Dr. Whoever, Blackjack. I would say the average listener is probably going to get at least half of this album that they're going to enjoy. The songs aren't too long. They get in, get their point across, and then they get out. You're not spending an hour trying to hear what he has to say. I like how it healthily talks about, you know, anxiety, healthily talks about depression in a way that's more realistic than it is trying to capitalize off of these popular things that affect a lot of youth. Amine, 1.5. Thank you all for watching. Let me know what your favorite tracks are in the comment section down below. I'm really excited to hear it. Let me know if you enjoy this as much as I do, if you do it all or if you don't at all. Again, I think it's a decent listen. Nothing crazy though, because I wasn't expecting anything crazy. But yeah, I thought it was okay. I'll see y'all next time, and I'm out. Base.